There is a distinctive feature in object-oriented programming, which is called inheritance, that has a big impact on programs involving sets of similar classes, and provides a solution to the problem of duplication. The main idea is to create a new class instead of just writing each kind of class independently. Create a new class that has everything that all the classes have in common, so that fields and methods that are present in all the classes are written only once in this new class, and the other extra details of the particular classes that are unique to each class are written there. This avoids write just the same code twice, so it avoids duplication. And in this particular case, we can write the class diagram to show how inheritance works in the case of message posted, photo post. A post class will be created with all the fields and methods that are in common with message post and photo post. So this class will contain as fields the username, the timestamp. Let's look at it. It's this timestamp. Likes and comments, and as methods, the methods that are in common, like and like, add comments. Get timestamp, display, and time string. Then the extra details of that are unique to each particular class will be written in their respective message post and photo post. So for message post, there will be an additional field that is called message, and then the additional field getText. While for the photo post, there will be file name, caption, as fields, and then I think get file name and get caption, no, get image file. And get caption. Now in the graph diagram, the inheritance relationship is drawn with hollow arrowheads. So the message post will point like this to, okay, this to post. And photo post like this. The post is called superclass. It is extended by other classes, which are called subclasses. It is the subclasses inherit the superclass. They extend it, we say in Java language there is a keyword extends, and so for example, message post inherits post, we can also say that message post extends post. So post is the superclass or the parent class, while the classes that extend the parent class or superclass are called child classes or subclasses. So in this case, we can see that the fields and the methods that are common to the subclasses are written in the superclass. While the subclasses have their particular, their unique fields and methods. The inheritance relationship is also called an is-a relationship because the subclass is a specification of the superclass. So message post is a post and photo post is a post. So message post and photo post, they all provide the fields that are both in their class and in the superclass. So message post will have all the fields that are in message post and in post, while photo post will have all the fields in photo posts and in post. The methods also will like every subclass will have all the methods in the subclass and in the superclass. So message post and photo post have the same functionality of post and more. So this basically avoids rewriting some code that is identical and solves this problem of duplication.